Today we're going to be talking about bringing the power of ARM to the server side. In a quick summary, ARM is making a huge insurgence in the market. ARM has obviously been doing a great job on mobile and IoT, but we're now at an inflection point in the industry where ARM is now ready and available for server-side computing. But it's more than just the actual microarchitecture. There's the infrastructure and the compute that we have to offer, and we're going to talk about what we're now launching today at OCI, our new Ampere Ultra A1 compute instance. Let's dig into more details about the platform, the CPU itself, as well as the new OCI compute instance that we're launching today. The Ampere Ultra A1 OCI compute instance is incredibly powerful, and there are three major reasons that customers are choosing it. The first is the highly predictable performance. The second is the improved security. And the third is that it has the most outstanding price performance available anywhere, whether it's in our cloud, in OCI, or in any other cloud out there. A few more details about the server and what we're offering. So we offer it in both bare metal and virtual machines. The bare metal servers have up to 160 cores, a terabyte of memory, and 2x50 gigabit per second networking. Our flexible VM offering is also available on our new A1 instances. And that means that you can configure separately the number of cores and RAM that you want to make sure that you're only paying for what you use. That brings us to the question, what can you do with the Ampere A1 compute? And the answer to that is, you can do a lot. There are some workloads that are common across all businesses. These are web front ends, they are application servers, they're containerized workloads, things like encryption, decryption workloads, as well as database workloads like MySQL. And the major thing that the Ampere A1 compute provides for those workloads is significantly improved price performance. And it's not just a little bit. Right? When we look at benchmarks across these different types of use cases, we see an upwards of 30% price performance improvement to the next best offering that we have available. If you go into specialized workloads, so let's take, for example, video streaming, maybe video streaming conferencing software or video streaming of live sports, what you can see is that the Ampere Ultra A1 processor and the new instances that we're launching today, they have higher peak performance, they have significantly improved price performance, and even more interestingly, they show significantly better performance scaling. And what that means is that you're always getting what you pay for. You're not getting variable performance based on whether you're using the minimum number of threads or the maximum number of threads. You always get the same performance that you expect all the time. We've talked a lot about the platform itself, and now it's time to talk about what we're doing in the ecosystem. Well, the first thing to recognize is that the ecosystem is actually already very rich. There are a ton of offerings available today, and you can see from this slide the huge variety of offerings already available. And I want to take a minute, though, to talk about what we at Oracle have been doing specifically. So if you look at things like Oracle Linux, MySQL, Java, and Graal, we've been investing very heavily in these technology platforms, in some cases for many years, to make sure that they run incredibly well on top of ARM, and more specifically, the Ampere Ultra processor. But we didn't stop with just the technology that we have at Oracle. We've been working in the industry with partners like GitHub and GitLab and Jenkins to make sure that they have the super integrated and high performance CI/CD pipelines needed for developers to bring their workloads to our cloud. In addition to that, we've been working with the Continuous Delivery Foundation to make sure that ARM and OCI are a first-class citizen and are very easy for all developers to use. In addition to those investments, we're also doing more to make sure that everyone has access to ARM and it's easy to use. So firstly, we created the ARM Developer Portal on OCI. And we on that place, it's a one-stop shop that gives developers access to all of the tools, documentation, and resources they need to have a really great experience developing ARM applications on OCI. Not everyone is familiar with the OCI free tier and our always free services, but for years now, we've given everyone who wants one an account, as well as a set of more than 20 services that they can use for free forever. And we're adding our new Ampere A1 instances to that. So anyone who has a free tier account, who already has it or signs up for a new one now or in the future, gets access to 4 cores of ARM compute, as well as 24 gigabytes of memory. But let's say that you just need more than you can get with the free tier to develop your application that contributes to the ARM ecosystem. For that, we've created the ARM Accelerator Program. And what that does is it gives you access to free credits to use towards developing the ARM ecosystem. We have a great website, you show up, you sign in, tell us about your project, and then we'll get back to you with free credits on enabling that use case. So we've jump-started the ecosystem, but now it's your turn to help. And to do that, it's actually not that hard. All we need you to do is to start your next hobbyist project on top of ARM A1 Compute. We need you to make sure that your open source project runs on the Ampere A1 instances. We need to make sure that whatever you can think of that will contribute to the ARM ecosystem, please, we're here to help, right? Come use what we're giving away freely available. Help contribute to the ecosystem. With that, what I do want to say is I want to say thank you to everyone.